Often in automation, we take in raw analog values, which represent some fluid level or pressure or temperature or some other process, and it's really handy when those raw numbers get converted automatically into inches, PSI, or temperature, or something that makes sense to us. Other times, the PLC may automatically convert the numbers, but we need them in point of view with different units or offsets or other modifications. Whatever the reason, point of view scaling feature is the answer because it does it automatically so you don't have to do any conversions yourself in the app, which makes your life easier. In this example, we have a potentiometer going into a Do More PLC. The Do More scale function is used to convert the raw numbers into 0 to 100 inches. We want point of view to fetch that and automatically convert it into centimeters. Here's what that looks like in the Do More code. We have an analog input coming in on port WX0, whose range is 0 to 4095. We want that to be scaled to 0 to 100 inches and input that result in R0, which is a real register. You can see that result here in the data view as I rotate the potentiometer. Now, as a reminder, you have to put a decimal point in these output values to get a real output. If I had put just a 0 and 100 here with no decimal point, that would tell the Do More to do integer math, and even though we have a real register specified, we would still get an integer result with no decimal values, so keep an eye on that. In point of view, we want that inches value down on the Do More to come in automatically in centimeters. We do that by using point of view's driver sheets. In this video, we'll assume that you're already familiar with driver sheets, but if you aren't, then check out the videos on how to use driver sheets to get up and running quickly. There's two ways to automatically scale numbers as they come into point of view, the driver sheet math method and the min-max method. First, we'll use the driver sheet math method. Let's create a tag to show the Do More raw input. We'll call that fluid level raw. And yes, we want to create this as an integer tag. The Do More is at this IP address. We don't need a CSV file here because we're not using any user-defined memory. And this is the name of the memory location on the Do More. Then we'll want the Do More's converted value in inches. Yes, we want to create this tag, but as a real. Same IP, and this is its name down on the Do More. And finally, let's create a tag to put point of view's automatically converted result in. We'll call that fluid level centimeters. And that needs to be a real, same IP address, and we want to convert that same inches value we brought in a minute ago. To convert inches to centimeters automatically in point of view, we just divide the incoming number by this scaling factor, and there's no offset, so we leave this blank. I've already created a screen with some text boxes to display the result. We have the raw fluid level, which is just that tag we created, the inches level, another tag we created, and the centimeters level, which is going to be the automatically created result. In all of these, I specified a number format with two decimal places. I also modified the viewer so I could resize the view to fit this video. Save all, run it. And sure enough, we get the expected values. Here's the raw Do More data, the inches value that the Do More creates and we just read in, and here's the centimeters value point of view scaled for us automatically. Easy. The second method is the min-max method. You specify the min-max of the incoming data and the min and the max that you want the local point of view tag to have. And point of view automatically does the magic to make it happen. To use this method, go to the driver sheet and click on this min-max checkbox. That changes these columns to min and max. So now we put the incoming tag's actual min and max here, which in our example is 0 to 100 inches. We can also put a global min and max here, which serves as the default for all rows if min and max aren't overridden on that row. I'll leave those blank so the values are just brought in as is. Save that. Now we go back to the global tab of the Project Explorer, select the tag we want to scale, and then on the Home tab, click on Tag Properties. Specify the scaled min and max here. Just for demo purposes, I'll pick a couple random numbers to scale it to. How about 57.4 to 475? Hit OK, run the project. And sure enough, this tag in point of view now runs from 54.7 to 475. Perfect. A couple notes. First, you can't access the tag properties by right-clicking on a tag and selecting properties. You have to use this menu version of the properties. Second, it's important to understand that whichever method you choose to convert data coming into point of view, it's automatically converted back when it heads back out of point of view. For example, suppose the PLC is sending point of view a temperature in degrees C, but we want it in degrees F. That equation is degrees F is degrees C times 1.8 plus or minus 32, or degrees C divided by 0.55 plus or minus 32, same thing. So we put 0.55 here and a minus 32 here, and point of view does the conversion for us in both directions. That is, if point of view writes data back out to the PLC, it does the exact opposite. It takes its degrees F, subtracts the minus 32, and multiplies it by 0.55. So the PLC always sees degrees C, and it's never aware that this scaling is being done in point of view. Let's run this example. Here's the point of view screen. I added this degrees F text box, and a do more data view. If we enter 25 degrees C on the do more, then point of view sees 77 degrees F. If we enter a 32 degrees F in point of view, then the PLC sees 0 degrees C. Exactly what we expect. So again, the PLC has no idea that point of view is working in degrees F. It always sees degrees C. That's really powerful because now you don't have to worry about how to handle reads and writes. It's all taken care of for you automatically. If you need any help, please contact Automation Direct's free tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at automation support staff there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.